Good morning, school. It feels like so long since we've been able to get together. Well, we've got an exciting things lined up for you today, so let's open with prayer. Good morning, Lord. Thank you for this opportunity and help us to make your name big. We love you. Amen. All right, so we'll start off with one, a worship song. This is a favorite of some of our friends. I hope you enjoy it too.
If you gotta start somewhere, why not here? If you gotta start sometime, why not now? If we gotta start somewhere, I say here. If we gotta start sometime, I say now. Through the fog, there is hope in the distance. From cathedrals to third world missions, love will fall to the earth like a crashing wave. Tonight's the night for the sinners and the saints to wait. Sometime, why not now? If we gotta start somewhere, I say here. If we gotta start sometime, I say now. Through the fog, there is hope in the distance. From cathedrals to third world missions, love will fall to the earth like a crashing wave. Tonight.
Awesome. The one thing we can still do, even if we're in lockdown, is we can pray. We can pray for our city, we can pray for the people that are sick, and we can pray for God to help us through this time, to help us become overcomers. Our guest today is from the Bridge Church in Alberton, and they've got an exciting message for us. All right, listen carefully.
Hi, Reddam House. My name is Justin. I'm from Bridge Church. I'll be your special guest today. Really, really excited to spend this time with you. A big, big thank you to Mr. Hazley and Mrs. Carl for inviting us here. We're excited for today. I hope you're excited. Thank you for watching this as well. Now, most of you don't know me, but one thing you need to understand is that I love a good challenge. I love overcoming challenges. And maybe you're similar to that as well. Let me tell you this. When I was in grade 10, I asked a girl out 5 times to be my girlfriend. I was very persistent. Now, I'm not saying that you need to ask a girl out 5 times, but what I'm saying is that that was a challenge that I had to overcome. And get this, 12 years later, we've been married for almost 3 years. We're still together. That was a challenge that we overcame. Now, we know that you love challenges. We've seen you do those TikToks, and we've been doing some too.
Don't rush. Slow touch, brown and white. I can go crunch, grab and bite. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, white rum, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go up.
How cool is that? So I dare you to do those same challenges. But the best thing about a challenge is overcoming that challenge, that you can win at that challenge, that you can look around and say, hey, I'm an overcomer. I overcame that challenge. And we want to be known as overcomers. We want to be known as overcoming lockdown, overcoming corona, overcoming homework, overcoming everything that we set our minds to. And we need to know, how do we become overcomers? Well, a great example of an overcomer was a man by the name of Joseph. And you can read all about him in Genesis 37 to 50. And he was a true overcomer. He overcame massive things that he had to deal with. And we can take real examples from his life. I wonder what Joseph would be like if he were in the South in this modern time right now. I think his name would be Jerome. This is Jerome. He lives in the South. Jerome has 10 brothers. But they're jealous. Jerome looks after animals. Jerome is the favorite son. His father gave him a Liverpool coat. Jerome has big dreams. But his name's not Jerome. His name is Joseph. What you need to understand about Joseph is that he was the 11th son. He was last born, but he was also the favorite son. And because of that, his brothers were so jealous of him. And what we need to know is that he still overcame that. He had big dreams. He never stopped dreaming. And he overcame every challenge that he set his mind to. Put yourself in Joseph's shoes. Now, look at what happened in Genesis 39. The Lord was with Joseph, so he succeeded in everything he did as he served in the home of his Egyptian master. Now, what we need to understand is that at this point, he was a slave. And the reason he was a slave is because his brothers were so jealous over him that they actually sold him as a slave. Well, they wanted to kill him, so maybe selling him was a better idea. They wanted to kill him. They wanted to throw him in a pit, but they sold him as a slave, and he had to overcome that challenge. And the key is that the Lord was with him. So Joseph had to overcome another challenge. You see, the thing is, he was being a good slave to his master Potiphar, but Potiphar's wife tried to seduce him and he wasn't interested. He wanted to honor Potiphar. So when she tried to come close to him, he ran away and she grabbed his coat and she went to Potiphar and she said, listen, Joseph tried to seduce me. Can you believe that? And because of that, he was put in prison. Another challenge. But Joseph is an overcomer. Look at this in Genesis. The Lord was with Joseph in the prison and showed him his faithful love. Can you believe that? Joseph was in lockdown for probably over 2 years. Imagine being in lockdown for 2 years. He overcame that challenge as well. Why? The Lord was with him. And later on, we can see that he kept overcoming all these challenges. Look at this in Genesis again. 41 verse 38. So Pharaoh asked his officials, can we find anyone else like this man, so obviously filled with the Spirit of God? How encouraging is that? Joseph was a true overcomer because God was with him. The important thing is that he never let his circumstances or anything around him dictate what he believed in. He trusted that God was with him, whether he was in prison, whether he was a slave, whether his brothers resented him. He was a true overcomer. See, you can also be a true overcomer. I can be an overcomer. We need to remember that God is with us. That's the first thing to remember. God is with us through the good times, through the bad, just like he was with Joseph. Joseph was a big dreamer. You can be a big dreamer too. Trust God and dream big. We can overcome this together. And the second thing is that God works in our works. That Joseph was faithful. He was full of faith. So one, God was with him. And two, he was full of faith. There's a saying that says, let go and let God. But in this case, God worked through Joseph's actions. So we need to remember that God works in our works. That yes, he's with us. But we need to move so that God can direct us. So just like Joseph, let's be overcomers. Let's be a generation of overcomers. What struggle do you need to overcome? Trust God and let's be full of faith. And again, be a generation of overcomers.